guys, Rob your Bears, and welcome back to my FIFA 17 Liverpool Chroma, where last time I left off, I picked up win over Cambridge United in the FA Cup third. I beat them 3-0, and I beat Watford in the first leg of my EFL World Cup. Whatever you want to call it. The League Cup. Let's just call it the fucking League Cup. Because that's what it is. But yeah, it was the first leg of the semi-final for the League Cup. I beat them 4-0. Oh, which is going to give me a tough decision to make on whether I'm going to play the second semi-final or sim it. Now, in this episode, I don't have the second semi-final. There's two league games in between, but that may change depending on the placement of the fourth round of the FA Cup, because I don't know when those games are taking place.
At this stage,
has been decided yet. It might be early February.
Trusty set of players down. I can see them continuing this form.
But if the we can also see Dele Alli, and I'll talk more about Dele Alli and his debut today. 70 million debut. Giving him the number 7, I'm going to have to change that. I want him to be number 20. Give him Adams. Since that's the number he is at Spurs. Keep that consistent. I mean, maybe he'll earn number 7. I don't know. Maybe I should keep it on him.
The Aston Villa team.
Maybe I should put it to a vote.
Despite looking shaky in recent games, and it's rounded off the team with these two strikers.
Oh. Oh wait, Renato Sanchez is number 20.
Today.
Yeah, he is.
With David Alaba as the fullbacks.
I actually have to change him because I was unsure what number he was for Bayern Munich, so I have to. Luckily, Bayern Munich were playing during the week. Sorry, Arsenal fans, don't mean to bring that up. But, look. But, he served the purpose. Renato Sanchez is 35.
Until that point,
at, Bayern Munich. I thought he was 20 possession. For some reason. I don't know why. Thiago is their number.
Well, I don't know who the lad saw there passing the ball. Somebody in the crowd.
So, I can change that. And here's the shot. I don't know, we'll see. Sadio Mane makes it 1-0. If the schedule doesn't change, the two games in this match, of course, are this game against Aston Villa and a Merseyside derby against Everton. Straight into the fire with Dele Alli's first two games, no? 70 million day. You will see how he does. 13 league goals for Sadio Mane, not quite. Third plus.
1-0 here.
I don't know why I keep bringing it up. It's not like it matters. It really doesn't.
Typified the competitive nature.
If you did miss the last episode that went up on Friday, you will have missed a lot. Not only is the addition of Dele Alli new, Emre Can is gone. He's gone. You will not see Emre Can in a Liverpool jersey in this career mode.
He can try and beat the keeper with power.
He is gone.
Bottom left.
He's gone. He actually went to Bayern Munich, weirdly enough. So I guess that's them replacing Renato Sanchez by buying one of my midfielders in that same area. Weirdly enough, Renato Sanchez was initially bought to replace Emre Can. And there you can see the confirmation. Sold him for 64.6 million. Looks like he got Renato Sanchez's number 35. Are you shitting me? Wow. That is unbelievably. Unbelievable coincidence. I wonder how they got to replace Alaba. I never figured that out. They might have just replaced him.
Just need to keep it going.
The shot's on. Got in the way. And in goes the cross.
Coutinho.
He's had a go.
Well, if you don't buy a ticket, as they say, and fair play to him for having a crack.
That will go down as a wasted chance.
Well, it was manna from heaven for any striker, but I think he's taken his eye off the ball there.
He's read that, hasn't he, and made the interception, made it look
easy. The 70 million man.
On the attack here. Aston Villa have possession again.
Yeah, that's why the game number 7. Because it signifies his price tag. Or part.
Here's Ali.
Nice bit of footwork.
70 million is a multiple of 7, I guess. That's, look at that, Dele Alli! Oh! If the defender didn't stop him at the last moment as I was taking the shot, that might have been a debut goal for Dele Alli. He might still set up something here. Origi! Debut assist for Dele Alli. He's 70 million for one assist. Why not? I mean, man, I pay 90 million for
Liverpool
for a League Cup down.
A long way out.
So
it's not always easy to finish.
Defenders caught out by it in the end.
Well, it's the anticipation.
I'm joshing.
Wasn't it just to get in front of his.
Dele Alli's. This is Dele Alli's first game. That was Pogba's 50th, if you include his first end at Manchester United.
Just widen the margin here to 2-0.
2-0, fantastic. Both strikers on the score sheet. And an assist by Dele Alli.
1-0.
Oh, interesting news again from Alan McAnally.
I was hoping it would be a Stoke goal, but of course it's Manchester City taking the lead.
Here's Alli.
Which is weird considering they'll need a replay to get through the third round FA Cup as Renato Sanchez scores goal number 3, which may take this game out of Villa's reach.
That does extend their margin now.
This is becoming like our last game against Villa before they got relegated. When even Colo Torre got in on the fucking action.
Liverpool really.
I think that's only like Renato Sanchez's third or fourth goal of the season.
The visiting team.
I've been banging them in, but then again, that's not what I bought him for.
These two teams met, but
chip in with a few goals. Was mostly
in the same stadium.
Run the midfield and get two assists.
To repeat, so it will be tough for them.
There is Renato Sanchez. He might get an assist here. Oh, he will pick it up though.
Here's the shot. Oh, he had a real go.
Well, you can't knock him.
Oh no,
he
man.
Just couldn't provide the finishing touch.
My business may not be done in the transfer window, though. You think I would be done after Dele Alli, but not yet. I think I'm going to get a few more players as Divock Origi scores goal number 4. That's his 27th of the season.
Scoring in any game is worthy of celebration. When you get two, it is special. And he is feeling that
beautifully
slot delight at the moment
in the corner. They're giving the Villa keeper absolutely no chance. He's been doing that all season, to be honest. This is getting a bit repetitive. This is definitely Divock Origi season, and he's making it very clear. And Daniel Sturridge is in good form, so he must be fucking sitting there like, man, I'm playing in the form of my life for the second team, and yeah, here's Dele Alli, and he's just banging them in left, right, and center.
Brilliant first half from this fella.
He's gotten a good few hat tricks already this season, and he might be about to get another one. Arsenal are winning, Chelsea are drawing, which so far they are the only other they're the only team up near me who are dropping points. United and Spurs aren't playing yet. Palace are winning. Arsenal are winning. And City are winning, of course.
Disappointing day for the midfield player who's been taken off now.
Oh yeah, I'm sure Gardner is going to make a huge difference.
He's better than we've seen today. It's a very much a lackluster performance by his.
And 4-0 down.
He'll be lucky to get a 4 in the morning newspapers.
Roberto from, you know, all cross, Matt, and he makes it 5-0 straight after the kickoff.
And they paid a heavy price.
Just over 2 minutes into the second half.
What a strike that was.
We're coming in from the...
This could be a long game.
Great ball, great goal.
Look at the players.
Brilliant header. Now Sadio Mane has his second of the game. Two from Mane, two from Origi, and a goal from Renato Sanchez. Only a Dele Alli goal could make this any better.
If you're losing count, it's
fine. I wouldn't say no to goals from Coutinho or Firmino or maybe both either. Or I mean, if we're going to score a lot of goals, we may as well spread it around. Which one of them is going to score the hat-trick now? Is it going to be Origi?
Here's a challenge.
He's going. I think he is on like 5 or 6 hat-tricks already this season. He's already banged them in. Sadio Mane.
Chelsea, there's a penalty. Ooh,
even though he's back and did a lot of goals in the 2.5 seasons so far, he hasn't won a lot of hat tricks.
He's got his shot off now.
Ivo Origi does, though. He just loves to score a hat trick.
It's a day he'll never forget.
55 minutes gone, and it's 6 now.
For him, a hat trick.
Not just 3 goals.
I think Villa will be wishing they were back in the championship. That's right.
It is the striker who's coming off. Striker who hasn't really struck in this game.
I'm surprised that's not the goalkeeper being subbed off.
He didn't work those channels.
As all the Villa substitutions, if they get an injury now, they will be. All sorts of screws. Palace has been scored by Marko Arnautovic. A drill. Crystal Palace have a third goal against Derby, which probably means their game.
57 minutes played. 3-0.
It looks like no one is dropping points. Maybe Chelsea.
Probing away, trying to find.
Depending on how their game ends up, but it looks like everyone is going to.
Half an hour to go.
Try their best to stay with me.
There's some potential in this move.
Dele Alli again, forced off the ball. Oh, with a shoulder tackle.
Chelsea did score.
It's a goal. He's still up there. Sadio Mane across the Dele Alli. He scores. And then it's of course goal number 7. Would you fucking believe it?
Before his debut for his new club, a debut day goal.
Would you even believe it?
Taken one, so couldn't have asked for any more.
Well, he gets the credit, and the credit was...
I mean, he got extremely lucky. If he hadn't scored, it might have been a penalty. It's his third goal in the Premier League. He'd only scored twice for Spurs. I thought he would have gotten a good few more. Oh,
totally one-sided, really, match, as the scoreline suggests.
No, I think Eriksen left, didn't he? I think he did, didn't he? This one, he went to Manchester United. Am I thinking maybe that was last?
The goal at Sellers Park, Alan.
It's a goal for Derby County.
Maybe
it's been scored by Johnny Russell.
Yeah.
Amazing run, cutting through the defence, slotting home.
I don't know. But
well, many thanks.
You think? Yeah, you would.
Keeping us up to date as usual.
Or in enough position that you would get.
Well, they got it wide very well.
The odd goal here and there. I mean, that's what he does in real life.
It's wonderful work from the goalkeeper again from the header.
Well, he was on his toes. He was very fit.
Bit stop.
Here's a chance to
meaningless
attack.
To compare real life and FIFA.
And they managed to score here.
I mean,
wonderful strike.
When was the last time Liverpool scored 8 goals in real life?
Well, here's the moment yet another goal for him.
He can do no wrong. Some matches, everything.
It's never been this easy. Jeez.
Let's have another peek at that goal.
8-0, four goals for Deepak Kareem. Sadio Mane is having a great game himself. Two goals and two assists. At least two assists. I haven't been really keeping track of who has assists and who doesn't.
There's only really one team in it. Only one team enjoying this.
He definitely has two assists.
Sometimes being a favourite.
Goal number seven and goal number eight.
Expectation and all that. It's not a problem for this team, is it?
No, I think their manager will be delighted because they've not taken it easily at all. They've given respect to their opponents, but they've shown their class too.
Sanchez.
Please,
And
here's the shot.
Off the post.
Fabulous clearance.
That should have been a set.
Left on the clock.
Ecking hat trick of the game.
Well, it's a nice bit of skill, but the defending, well.
It's Miss Renato Sanchez! Oh, ring! His shot is smashed into the body of the Villa keeper. It should have been five goals for Timo Origi.
And he's met it with his head.
And Mane's header is
well, you'd fancy the lad to score.
Taken by the keeper despite the bounce.
Still had a lot to do, and he did it really well.
It's looking good, this move.
Foul.
Aston Villa giving away the free kick. It was their foul.
Fretout. He's booked.
It's going to be a yellow card for this player.
For his challenge on David Alaba.
Firmino!
Oh, I tried to get... I didn't get enough on it. Tried to just drop it into the perfect position, but Firmino just didn't get the connection I was envisioning on it. He just kind of just hit it, but he didn't like direct it.
Good reading of the play.
I didn't go at all as planned.
Challenges for the ball. Renato Sanchez.
Did I come off? It would have been fantastic.
4 minutes still to come of added time.
4 minutes. It made Firmino look like weirdly the worst performer of the game. At least from a Liverpool standpoint.
Ben Me.
Because almost everyone else has been fantastic. Although Coutinho's been a bit quiet.
As a match, it was rather one-sided,
that
wasn't it?
Can be forgiven.
Capacity.
Like I said, I wasn't really paying attention to who assisted the goals, because so Coutinho and Firmino each having an assist, pair of assists each. Let's actually have a look. It's the wrong one. I'm going to go into this one. Wow! Both Mane and Origi got 10s. Like, everyone got at least an 8 except for Karius. But that's probably because he didn't do anything. I don't think he touched the ball. Oh. Well, let's see. Assists. Firmino did get an assist. Oh, Dele Alli got 2. And Mane got 3. 2 assists and a goal on his debut. Ooh, not bad. Not 70 million worth, but not bad. Chelsea 1. Brilliant.
Arsenal 2.
I mean, Spurs.
Everton 1. Aston Villa.
Man City, sorry. Liverpool, yeah, 8. Drew. Chelsea, since they 2. Dropped points.
Hull City 1.
But all in all,
4. Derby
bad,
County,
bad,
1.
Bad. Other Manchester results. Other results didn't go my 1. Way, so
Newcastle United,
no real
2.
Gap Sunday, open.
1.
Stoke City, 1. Except against Manchester City.
City. 1. Tottenham Hotspur.
Kitchener goes up to West a 65 rate. One. Maybe that'll attract a bit more attention.
One. Swansea City.
Two.
So what do those
yes. And
the
top
of the table.
You're probably wondering what you're looking at that, probably saying, why is he offering 18.5 million? Because this player is Danny Alves's region. That's why I'm offering so much. Because he is
in fifth,
going to be
Tottenham Hotspur with 36 points. In sixth, West Bromwich
Albion. I was looking at his stats. In seventh, like, Chelsea. Damn, this guy looks really good. And you're probably saying to yourself, how do you know he's Daniel Alves?
Derby County with
because
points.
He's Brazilian. And I looked, Daniel Alves is gone.
West Ham United with 18 points.
I even searched for him, and he didn't come up, so...
Third bottom, Southampton with 18 points, but only behind...
Putting two and two together, but... Fourth bottom, you know, it seems like it's making four. Points.
Fifth yeah. bottom and falling are Sunderland.
He wasn't there, points. And... This guy... is a region who is a right back from Brazil. Well, yeah, that's in the Serie A as well. I mean, that if that's not Daniel Alves' region, it is a massive fucking coincidence. And if it's not his region, where the fuck is he? Oh. I do not believe that. I didn't think that transfer would go through. I did not expect them to accept the first offer. I really didn't. Because this guy looks good as well. He's Albanian. I have no idea who the fuck this guy is, but his stats look unreal. Ooh. And that's not even as well even having scouted him. Yeah, you're fine, man. I don't even need him. See, I was offering Ragnar Klavan. Oops, no, I didn't want to attend the press conference. Dream on that leg, on with Rick. I mean, come on, 30 million for Joel Matip. Oh, what is it with the teams in this game and smoking some screwy shit? I don't want to attend press conferences. Jesus Christ, they should have an option in FIFA 18 to have those be that you can turn those off. If you're gonna do anything, EA, if you add one feature, add that. Oh yes, Birmingham City, have a gander, fantastic. That's exactly what I wanted to see. He'll be back again. We will not see Benjamin Kisha until January 23rd, 2021. Oh well. tournament prize money, that's probably the FA Cup. I mean, my rating has gone down for some reason. I don't know why. Ah, oh, beautiful. I mean, I just absolutely secured the future of the defense. And I thank Ragnar Klavan. He was fantastic throughout the two seasons. But I mean, 76 rating, which is a fantastic rating, and a 75 rating. I mean, he's already on the same level as Ragnar Klavan, because Ragnar Klavan was a 76 rating. He was going down. This guy is only going to go up. Look at his stats. Look how fast he is for a centre back. 85 strength as well. Oh, and there you can see, he's Albanian. And just so you can see, Brazilian as well. I mean, like, the only other person it could be is maybe Maicon? But, you know, maybe it is Maicon, but that wouldn't explain where Dani Alves' region is gone, because Dani Alves is gone. I don't even know if Maicon still plays in Serie A. So, I'm assuming it's Daniel Alves. I mean, if I'm wrong, whatever. But I don't think I am. A I think I've sourced out two absolute gems. And that gives me more rotational choices for the second team, which is exactly what I wanted. Now, ideally, I want to get a right midfielder. I haven't figured out who I'm going to get for that position yet. I want someone I can rotate with my main man and Alexander-Arnold. Reject all offers. I'm not selling the phone. Sorry, Napoli. Not interested. You don't have the correct amount of cash. Because, there is no amount of cash that would get him away from me. Oh, did I forget to, ask? My bad, man. I'll quickly do that now, man. My bad. I'm gonna have to offer him more now because he's probably he'll think I was blue-balling him. What the fuck you call it? Trent Alexander-Arnold. Squad rotation. I'm gonna up it to 100k because he's looking for a just. No, make him feel appreciated. 5 goals this season, that's not bad. He scored 2 of those in the last episode. Well, he was on fire in the last episode. But, yeah. Transfer window be damned. This is going to be a long episode, but I might have to cut out a few bits. I'll see what I can do about that. I'll leave Crystal Palace because they're near the top again. Nah, I want to keep an eye on the teams that are directly near me. You know. See if we can't repeat the performance against Villa against Everton. Come on, thing. There we go. Press option to play. I was waiting for it to pop up.
Yeah, Liverpool, no cares. I think they're a good side. You know,
jump straight into the game.
Away victory.
Let's go.
Against Aston Villa.
Yeah, one of those.
Their second.
But I think we're going to see them through
the season, of course. I already beat Everton at Goodison.
The Liverpool side. Lloris Karius is the goalkeeper today.
Origi! Ooh! Bowman had to be on his guard to make sure. I didn't
the ball broke
score
through.
A nice early goal.
It's always been a wonderful ground Anfield for Liverpool.
He's got his shot off. Dele Alli.
He's missed the target.
Not the best shot, is it?
The end.
But Dele Alli, no stranger to Derby. Of course, he'd be more familiar with the North London Derby between Arsenal and Spurs rather than the Merseyside Derby. But he'll get accustomed to a change, no doubt. I'm sure the other players would fill him in with his. I'm sure he's taking some notice of it. I mean, before Spurs signed him, he was almost signed by Liverpool. And Brendan Rodgers.
Hamid Bezic. James McCarthy.
That's not even a rumor or a joke.
A bit of menace to it.
Dele Alli confirmed that himself when he was interviewed by Sky Sports. I think it was before
a game, they might have been through them with that
game against Liverpool.
But the defence just shut the door on them.
I almost ended up as a Liverpool player.
into the attacking third.
If things had been different, we might be seeing Dele Alli in a Liverpool shirt.
Could be a chance here for Liverpool. Diogo Jota.
And not just in FIFA. Haven't been bought for 70 million.
Mohamed Bezic just lent the ball to his mate and got it back again. James McCarthy comes in strongly. Possession given
Roberto
away.
Firmino.
Good forward play from.
I'll get past the Everton players.
Tackle.
Stasic clears it. He used to play for Manchester City. Is that the same one?
Yes, Al.
I mean, that could be a different one.
Turnover there that we didn't expect. There's good progress with this attack. Roberto Firmino.
Origi! Off the post!
He's given the free kick.
I think someone was flagged for offside, but...
One not to miss.
Still,
here on EA Sports.
Imagine. I mean, it wouldn't have counted, but imagine if he had scored that.
They'll be hosting Watford.
Well, an awful lot of pressure on both sides. It's just a question of who can play their football in this one.
Well, no shots at all. This is how they love to play on the break.
Origi! Off the post again!
Post! Throw him for Liverpool.
Twice in almost. It's back to back, he's hit the post. Un-freaking real.
And shoots! A good hit at it, but I'm afraid it was off the radar.
Everton probably he requested to borrow that.
I think Liverpool
goal post. Anytime they're playing against me in the future.
On the front foot now.
Be a corner.
Hoping for the goal. Sasic
got
the
us before already. To prevent him getting
strike.
Goal! I think it's giving it as a Roberto Firmino goal. I think it was Matip with the header. But it must have taken some sort of hit off Roberto Firmino because he's the one celebrating. I mean, yeah, it's a goal for the team, but he's specifically the one I was controlling as the celebration was going on.
In prime fashion.
It's not a coincidence. They've scored plenty of times from these kind of corner kick situations.
I can see him. Hang on a second. I know I'm... Oh, his arms and shoulder. Oh my god. Ooh. A controversial goal opens the scoring in the Merseyside derby. Oh, Everton fans would be up in arms about that if that were happened in real life.
Especially the points that they got for winning the away game.
Sayo Mane. There's something they be up in arms about. Oh, good save from the keeper again. Oh.
Here's the shot. Shot blocked here. Lukaku. And that's half time.
Crystal Palace are drawing as well. Also, that goal is key here right now. But to gain 2 points on
at Anfield, the
Palace.
Second half is now underway.
It doesn't sound like it should be a thing, but it is a thing because they're really
Jota.
Performing.
And the attack coming out of from skin. Everton.
And as of late, they were.
He does read the game well. This
third
time.
Last season.
In comes the challenge.
And they're intent. They seem intent on trying to match that or better at this.
The Everton player.
Yeah, they're gonna have to go a long way to better at by more than one spot because they're still miles behind me.
The tackle there is. He's got his shot off now.
Deflected off Gabriel for the corner.
And the stoppage in play means the substitution can take place, and it's going to be a double substitution.
Coutinho.
The shot gets blocked.
Deflection cleared by Coleman. Barker. He's going to get further away.
Ross Barkley. Dele Alli. McCarthy. We've had an hour gone here, and still 30 minutes left.
Well done, David Alaba. Here's Dele Alli.
Potential in this move.
Renato Sanchez.
Spotted well.
Ah! Cut it out. I was trying to pass it through to Sadio Mane, but it didn't come off. Phil Coutinho. Whip it in. Origi! 2-0! Celebrating right in front of the Everton fans just to rub it that much away.
What a great goal that was, Alan.
The defenders seemed to lose the concentration almost. They saw it coming from a long way out. But he's just got ahead of his marker, pure and simple, and he wanted it more.
If I'm not mistaken, that's goal number 29 for the season. For Divock Origi. I mean, surely not again. Surely it's not going to happen.
Just widen the
two seasons in a row. I mean, Sadio Mane passed it last season, becoming only the second player to do so. And since then, someone else has done it. Two other players have done it in my secondary career mode. Let's do it.
Building steadily here, keeping
one man's even reached 50 goals.
And in goes the cross.
Surely Origi's not going to pass 40, is he? Surely not.
Divock Origi.
I mean, 11 goals between now and the end of the season.
He's through.
Nah, right?
That tackle has got in the ball.
I was pressing circle and they were doing nothing. What the f***? Stupid cunts. Sometimes.
Good forward play from them. Time ticking on. Just over.
Oh my god.
15 minutes to go. Shots on here. You've got in the way.
Deflection. Ah, oh, I thought Mane was going to get there. He wasn't running at full pace. What the hell? Osadio.
Here's Renato Sanchez.
Dele Alli.
And here comes the counter-attack. Strong challenge. He's got his tackle.
Sadio Mane puts it out for an Everton throw.
Ross Barkley.
Brilliant.
Gabriel Paulista. Could be dangerous. Substitute for Everton. Lukaku. And shoots!
Oh, good save, Karius. First save he's had to pull off in a while. I think Barkley might have been hurt there when he went into that challenge with Joel Matip.
Lukaku!
Oh, another good save from Karius. Back to back.
Number 10.
Barkley was injured.
No!
Oh, Yannick Bolasie, you cunt!
To just one goal now, and they'll be hoping to use the time profitably.
Karius came out to punch it, and Bolasie hit it into a fucking empty net. Brilliant.
I think the goal scorers made the most of that corner because it was just a standard floaty ball into the box.
Oh, well done, the goalkeeper, and he's hung on to the ball. And it's going to be a minimum of 3 minutes to be played of added time. Tackle here. Origi. And that's the...
Fucking bullshit, man. That Everton goal was so bullshit. Why did Karius come to punch it?
Crystal Palace.
I didn't tell him to do that.
Newcastle United 1. Leicester City 1.
That's the sort of thing. In that they do in real life.
Everton 1. Middlesbrough 2.
That's why we can see so many goals from fucking corners and crosses and set plays and whatnot. Now let's see what it's because of a goalkeeper made a stupid decision.
At the top of the table remains.
How
Liverpool
fucking retarded can you be? I'm gonna end it there. Thanks for watching. Hope you enjoy. Smash the like button if you did. Subscribe if you're new. And until next time, I hope you all have a very, very nice day. Peace.